Hey guys, this is ShyGamerMaile and welcome back to the channel. Today I have a very special reaction video. This is Kingdom Hearts 3. It's part of a long-running series by Square Enix. They make games like Final Fantasy and Dragon Quest, and most recently Project Octopath Traveler, which I've played a little bit on the channel. This is one of the games I've been waiting for the longest. The last numbered Kingdom Hearts game, Kingdom Hearts 2, came out around 2005, I believe. And it's 2019 now, so we've been waiting for this game for 13 years. I've actually already played through the game once on normal difficulty. It's a pretty short game, about 20 to 25 hours, if you're kind of just going through the main story like I did. But today I'm going to start a proud run of Kingdom Hearts. Standard difficulty was a little too easy for me, so I thought I'd just share my reaction, talk about what I like about Kingdom Hearts 3 so far. There will be no spoilers, so you don't have to worry about leaving. I'm thinking about doing a video about my thoughts about this game later on, because they were kind of mixed. But for now, let's jump right into Kingdom Hearts 3. We're gonna go to New Game. And we've got three difficulties here. There's Beginner, Standard, and Proud. Usually Kingdom Hearts has four difficulties. There's one called Critical Mode, but as of right now, Kingdom Hearts 3 does not have a Critical Mode, so we're just going to head on over to Proud, and we're going to begin the game with this difficulty. This is a good brightness. And here we go. There's going to be a beautiful cutscene at the beginning of this game. Kingdom Hearts games are kind of known for their gorgeous CG openings that are just chock full of foreshadowing and meaning, and they have gorgeous music, so I can't wait for you guys to see that, but let's jump right into the game. Be nice and quiet so you guys can hear the cutscenes.
Have you heard of the ancient Keyblade War?
Huh? Of course I have.
Long ago, Keyblade wielders waged a war over the ownership of light.
Yeah, the Master's favorite story.
I wonder what they planned on doing with Kingdom Hearts after making it appear.
Who knows? I don't get why anyone would initiate a war.
So, you know the Lost Masters?
Who?
They're the ones who started the Keyblade War.
Never heard of them. Where'd you hear about that?
Or, they're the ones for whom the war started.
I'm not following you.
You can drop the facade.
facade.
On that land shall darkness prevail and light expire. A prospective Keyblade master should know this.
If you say so.
The gazing eye sees the fate of the world. The future. It's already been written.
Really? I'm not so sure about that. Besides, who's to say I can't change it? And maybe light will prevail.
Pretty confident. But things aren't in your favor.
Perhaps, but unlike darkness, there is more light than meets the eye. You might be surprised.
Oh, I hope so.
They can take your world. They can take your heart. Cut you loose from all you know. But if it's your fate, then every step forward will always be a step closer to home.
Thank you. watch me cry all my tears.
Alright, so this first section of the game right here is called the Dive to the Heart. There are 7 hearts to save. This is called the Dive to the Heart, and it's basically the tutorial section of the game. Shows you how to handle the controls and everything. All of these scenes we got going on are from the previous games in the series. So that's from 1. Still from 1. The end of 1. And that's from the start. What do you desire? So in this section, the Dive to the Heart, you get 3 choices, and they actually determine the way in which Sora will grow throughout the playthrough. You didn't see this in 0.2, but in the other main games, this is a thing. So you can choose Wisdom, Vitality, or Balanced Power. So basically, this will give you high magic and then low attack. This will give you high defense and I think low magic. And then this is a balance between the two. Normally, I like to be a little more aggressive in the game, but this game made magic a little bit more viable, so I'm going to go for a balanced approach. Balance, a body and mind of equal merit and equal potential. Is this what you desire? Yes. You're gonna get 1 more choice like this. Right here to further fill out stuff. Alrighty. What power do you seek? So again, here's 3 paths. This is the Guardian, raise defense. The Warrior, raise attack. Or the Mystic, raise magic. I like attacks a fair bit more, so we're gonna go for the Warrior. The power of the Warrior, invincible courage. Is this the power you seek? Yes. Is this who you are? Yes. This is just a basic tutorial. I've already played through the game, so I don't need to really worry about this. Pretty easy little tutorial. Just defeat the enemies on screen, and we're good. And it's Darkseid, Heartless again, from First Kingdom Hearts game. And if you watched our playthrough of 0.2, he was actually in there too. Oof. I didn't get the shockwave in time. Almost done. Gonna just ignore the Heartless on the ground. You got staggered there. That's a thing in this game. I don't believe it's something that can happen in 1 or 2. Because I don't believe I've ever had that happen to me, but maybe it is, and I just don't know. For some reason, I always go for this hand. A couple more hits, and we should be good. Gotcha. We got our fire and water spells out of that. Help me remember. I just wanted to show you guys this menu real quick. If you've never played Kingdom Hearts before, this menu is here to help you out. It's got short little videos that will summarize the plot of the previous games. I haven't actually sat down and watched these myself because I followed the series. I've only played 4 of the games. 1, 2, Chain of Memories, and Dream Drop Distance, but I've kept up with the story throughout the years through just watching summary videos and lore videos. So I didn't need to watch this, but you guys might have to. They don't exactly go in depth about anything, so it might be better to watch a YouTube video if you want to catch up on the series lore. So you don't necessarily have to have played the series before in order to enjoy Kingdom Hearts 3. You can jump right in and just read through this or watch this, and you'll get a rough idea of what's happened. But for the best experience, I would say you should probably play through at least 1 and 2, and then at least watch a couple of lore videos. There are some short ones that can be done in like 30 minutes. But I'm not going to watch any of these. We're just going to continue right on into the main game. I am good for now. We're going to go into another bunch of cutscenes right here that link 0.2 into Kingdom Hearts 3.
There are allies we must gather, acting now to rouse them from their slumber. We have discussed this before, Sora. Your Mark of Mastery exam was conducted in the hopes you would acquire the power to wake them. However, the darkness nearly took control of you, and your grasp of your new abilities leaves much to be desired. Furthermore, Xehanort nearly made you his vessel, and in the process stripped you of most of the power you had gained by then. I suspect you have already noticed this, correct? But first, you must regain all the strength you have lost. Perhaps it is foolish to expect a complete recovery, but it is absolutely vital you perfect one power. The power of waking, which you failed to master during your exam. There's someone who lost his strength and found it again. A true hero to whom you ought to pay a visit. Perhaps he can point you in the right direction.
Got it.
You can count on us to take care of Sora.
I would have it no other way. I put Sora in your hands.
And don't forget, we'll keep an eye on you.
Oh, this is gonna be lots of fun.
It's not a vacation. Let's go.
Count on us.
How are we supposed to get there now?
What? I thought you knew.
Looks like all the old highways are closed. Didn't Master Yen Sid say that Sora should trust the guidance his heart gives?
Come on, Sora! Which way? Hey, would you get serious?
Give me a break. I'm trying. These things take time.
Well, since we've already been before, why don't you try picturing our friends like we're there?
Wow. Sorry, I got nothing. What did you expect?
May your heart be your guiding key.
Huh? What's that?
Master Yen Sid always said that, right before we went off on any of our real important adventures.
Really? Ring a bell?
Maybe I just imagined it.
May my heart be my guiding key. I've got it! Right! Olympus Coliseum, here we come!
At long last, the time had come. The planets were edging into perfect alignment. And the plan Hades devised 18 years ago was about to reach fruition. The fates had predicted this very future, the day he would seize control of Olympus and rule over all the cosmos. Hades' previous attempts, using Terra, Cloud, and Orin to advance his plans for conquest, had failed. The hour was not yet right. But now the planets were aligned, and nothing could possibly go wrong. A wave of darkness lanced down from their celestial rank, and one by one, Hades freed the Titans from their prison. Some of them, the same monstrosities that Sora and his friends had already fought and bested before. With both the Titans and his longing for vengeance against Zeus reinvigorated, Hades began his attack on Olympus.
These loading scenes are hilarious. It's like a little Instagram for the characters. Very cute. Kind of out of character, but very cute. Nice way to transition between cutscenes.
Huh?
Uh
No fanfare?
Nope. Looks like we missed the Colosseum.
Sarah, you opened the gate.
I was a little off again. Sorry. We'll find him. But we need to go.
Up the mountain?
Yeah. Up is the usual direction.
Well, never hurts to have your head in the clouds.
Exactly. Hey, we're leaving.
Alrighty, we're back in the game. Let's head into the main body of Colosseum. First bunch of enemies right here. Alright, we've got magic, but until I set it to a shortcut, it's really inconvenient to use because you have to use the directional pad to go down to use it. So, for now, we're just gonna stick to physical moves. There we go. One thing I will say about this game is that it is absolutely gorgeous. Just look at all the work that they've put into it. Square Enix has always been just really graphically amazing. Kingdom Hearts, Final Fantasy, whatever they make is always friggin' gorgeous. So let me hop into the menu real quick. We're gonna go to shortcut A, set this, then we're gonna set water should probably be here. I'm gonna just put them on keys that I'm familiar with. Abilities. I don't think there's anything I can really equip to these guys right now. But this is another thing I really like about 3. It added a bunch of verticality by letting you run on walls like this. Just gonna jump up, scale this wall again.
I think we might be going in circles.
Did I make a turn at the wrong rock? Hey, Hercules! Where are you?
First world, the Colosseum. Or Olympus, I guess, in this game. Usually it's just called Colosseum.
Oh. All right, I know I dotted my I's, crossed my T's, zeroed the hero. So what gives? Who could possibly be trying to give me a migraine by yodeling that Yutz's name?
Really? Hades?
It's just you.
It's just us? Even for you, that's cold.
Don't forget, I can always turn up the heat!
Wait, if Hades is here, then where's her?
What is everyone's infatuation with that stone? Never mind. I'm cool. I'm good. Because Wonder Boy will be out of my hair soon enough.
So you're up to no good again.
Of course he is.
You're back.
Oh, easy. What is this, Sparta? Kind of on a schedule. Don't have time to toss around the old fire and brimstone. The whole cosmos is basically waiting for me to, you know, conquer it.
Poor Hades. He thinks he can actually pull it off this time.
Where are my titans? Show me your power! That sent him sailing. Sailing right to where I left. No biggie. Nice work, boys. So, back to the whole cosmic coup thing? Really? Are you kidding? Jeez Louise. Seriously, when it rains, it pours. Okay, who's the new pest?
Hey now, that ain't no way to say hello, especially to your old friends.
Ah, perfect. Now I gotta put up with you too. Funny, I don't remember you doing me any memorable favors. So, you can keep your heartless this time. I'm going back to my original plan, all right? So, toodaloo, exits that away. Hey, it was great seeing ya. Happy trails!
We are not here for you. I have my own business to attend to. All I need to know is if there is a distinctive black box somewhere in this world.
Black box, huh? Black box, black box, black box. Wait. Don't tell me. You're after the one Zeus hid on Earth?
Possibly. If I were, where might it be?
Phew.
See? Found him.
Yeah, I guess this counts.
Put me down!
Just a second.
You guys are here! Sora!
Donald!
Goofy! You literally dropped in!
Gotta say, I'm impressed.
Thanks!
Like the catch!
Yeah, thanks, Herc. But what's going on?
Take a guess. Starts with an H.
Ah, I get the picture. Actually, we bumped into the H-ster on the way here.
He said something about conquering the whole cosmos.
All of it, huh? Nice of him to show a little self-restraint. Well, whatever he's planning, I'll send him running back across the Styx.
That's our Herc.
Alright, so we're at our first save point. First, let's take a look at the Moogle shop. Grab. We're not gonna grab anything for now since we only have a paltry 63 money. But we will definitely be able to buy something later on in this world. So, it's been about half an hour, so I'm gonna stop right here, and then next time we are going to get into more fights and I can show off more of this gorgeous game. So I'll see you guys on the next part. This is ShyGamerMaile, signing out. See you guys later.